Resource Central. I'm Joe Reinecker. Today, our guest is the Chanute Coordinator for Skill, Sharon Traylor. Sharon, welcome to Resource Central.
Hello, how are you?
Pretty good. 6 weeks ago, you guys started a woodworking class. How is that going at this point?
Well, it's kind of went from woodworking to arts and crafts, but we have some cool projects going on, and everybody seems really interested.
That's the most important thing anyway.
I think so, too. So,
what's everybody doing?
They're making rocking chairs. The last one we went, of course, we've only had one where everybody actually got together and did something. And they're making these little rocking chairs that are, like, put a picture in the back of them, and they're just a knick-knack thing. And the next project is supposed to be a wall plaque where it's got all the months of the year and people's birthdays and family kind of plaque thing. And they're wanting to make roses out of spoons and just all kinds of cool stuff.
Just how creative are these people?
Just what? Oh, well, they're very creative as long as somebody directs them. But that's okay, because I have a lady that comes in when we do the classes, and she loves to do arts and crafts. So it's working out really, really well.
What's the lady's name?
Her name is Vicki Patterson.
How long's she been working with you?
Well, really, she just started officially about a month ago. She come in and we talked about doing this a few months, but then last month is when she actually came and did a thing with them, and that was on the 29th. And so we put the next one for the 19th. So when they get back, everybody gets back in the office. We're going to have another one and see how far we go from there.
During a year's time, how many woodworking classes or arts and crafts classes do you have?
I hope to have 2 a month is what I hope. But we'll just see how it takes off because, you know, we've just started, so they could lose interest. And then again, they might just want to do it 3 times a month. I mean, I really don't know. But I would like to do it twice a month.
As you see it, what do arts and crafts classes do for the consumers?
Well, for one thing, it builds confidence. And it gives them a chance to socialize and be part of a group, you know, to other than, like, the coalition meeting. They come, they meet, they eat, they go home. This is more informal. It's more, you know, hey, I need help with this, or what do you think of that? Or it gives them, I think, a better chance to socialize and feel like they're included in something. And, you know, in here, everything is normal, no matter what. It's normal. So I think it's really good for their self-confidence too.
Do you feel like it's a different way to interact?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I'm not just, you know, being a person that's, you know, looking up stuff or checking on stuff for them. I'm actually someone that's doing something along with them, which puts me on the same level as them, and I love that too.
I can see why you would. What are the big projects you got planned for everybody once they can get back in the office after the conferences and stuff?
I hope they finish the rocking chairs because everybody really liked those, and I only had 5. I felt really bad that we didn't have more. But I'm just kind of would like for them to decide what all they want to do so that, you know, they have the input and all that. I do know they want to make stuff for... They're hoping to have enough stuff by September to do an artist alley booth, but we'll see.
Ooh,
we'll see.
Be
it might have to be a year down the road, but, you know, I kind of would like for them to more or less decide what they want to do. I don't want to pick stuff. I want them to.
Have you guys have you figured out in your own mind if they finish the chairs, who would get them?
They will. Yeah, they're making them for themselves.
Okay. I thought they might be making them for the public use.
No, they're making them. They all like them, and so, you know, it's like the jewelry thing. If you make it, you keep it. You know.
Let them have something.
Right, unless you want to donate it. If you make it, you keep it.
Yeah, let them have something. Give them something of their own.
Yeah, and a lot of them, I have one lady, if when we do the wall plaques with the months and the birthdays and everything, the family things, she's wanting to make a couple of them for Christmas presents for her kids. So, mm-hmm. you know, she can keep them and give them to whoever she wants, you know.
What other things are you guys doing in Chanute?
Well, I'm still doing the jewelry days, and we have the coalition meeting that goes on once a month, and I guess, you know, I've had several people come off the waiting list here lately and just staying busy.
How many people come to your office on a weekly basis?
Oh, my goodness, on a weekly basis. Well, let's see. If you count the repeat offenders, I would guess maybe 10 or 12, you know, with people coming in to ask questions or you know, people that just come in to sit and visit. I have those.
That's cool.
Yeah.
How are we doing on time, Andy?
About that time.
Thank you, Sharon. This has been Resource Central. I'm Joe Reinecker. Our guest today has been Sharon Traylor, the coordinator of the Chanute office. Sharon, welcome. It's been a pleasure to have you on Resource Central today.
All right. Well, thank you so much, and you have a good day.
You too. Thanks.